There are certain animations that are commonly found in a lot of different applications. They're common because people are used to the way they feel, and they're good at conveying interactions and the meaning behind them. One of these types of animations is a flip animation, where you have some content, and then through some sort of interaction, it needs to flip over and reveal the content from the opposite side. Well, this is what we're going to create in this video. However, before we can create and add our flip animation, we need to include the animations module in our application. In order to do this, we need to add the providers array to our Bootstrap application function. Then we need to include the provide animations function within this array. Okay, now we can add animations. For this example, I've already created a basic animation component to get us started. If we look at the code for this component, we can see that there's not too much to it. All we have is a flipped signal, which is what we'll use to trigger the flip animation. If we look at the template, we can see that it too is pretty simple. Here, we have a container div, which is where we will apply our animation. This is the element that will be flipped. Within this container, we have the div for side A, which is the element that we want to see before we flip it. Then, we have the div for side B, which is what we want to see after we flip it. Now, the reason that we see side B right now is because it's stacked on top of side A currently, since it comes afterwards in the markup. And under the container, we have the button that is used to toggle the flipped property when clicked. Okay, so that's what we're starting from. Now let's add the animation. Let's switch back to the TS. Okay, to add animations, we need to use the animations array in the component metadata. Then within this array, we need to add a trigger function from the animations module. Then we need to give this trigger a name. Let's call it flip. Now for this animation, we aren't going to be able to do everything with Angular animations alone. We're going to need to add a little bit of CSS too. What we are going to handle with Angular animations is the flipping between false and true states. So we can add the first state with the state function from the animations module. Now we need to provide the state as a string to this function. We'll start with the default state, when our flip property value is false. So we need to add false as a string for the default state. Now we need to provide a style object for this state using the style function from the animations module. We'll be using the transform property to flip this container. So for our default state, we can just set our transform property to none. Okay, that's it. Now we need to add another state for our true flipped state. Then we need to add the style object for the style we want to animate too. For this, we want to rotate the container element halfway around the y-axis. So we'll use the transform property, and then we'll use the rotate y function, and we'll rotate 180 degrees. Okay, now we have both states. Next, we need to set up a transition between these two states. For this, we can use the transition function from the animations module. For this function, we need to provide an expression for the states to transition between. In this case, we'll animate from the false state to true. And the way that we ensure that this transition will run both when switching from false to true and true to false is with this arrow pointing both directions here. Okay, now to finish this off, we need to add the animate function. This is where we can provide the duration and optionally an easing function. Let's go with a duration of 0.8 seconds. And then let's go with ease in out to give the animation some easing. Okay, that's everything we will be adding as far as Angular animations go. So let's go ahead and wire this up in the template now. To bind this animation to the value of our signal, we wrap the trigger in square brackets. And then we just need to add our flipped property. So when flipped is false, we'll be in our default false state. Then when it switches to true, we'll transition to our flipped true state. Okay, now we have the flipping part of the animation set up, but remember I mentioned that we need to add some CSS. Well, first, we need to stack side A on top of side B. We can do this by adding a z-index to the side A div. Okay, now we need to flip the side B div 180 degrees so that when we flip the container, it'll be facing in the correct direction. Also, we need to set backface visibility to hidden on our container. This prevents the back of the flipped element from showing when facing the opposite direction. Okay, let's give it a try. Now when we click the button, we can see that it flips back and forth. But it doesn't look great, does it? It really looks more like it's simply shrinking and growing. Well, this is because we need to add some 3D effects to these elements. The first thing we need to do is add the perspective property to the element containing the animated container. In this case, that's our host element. This property will provide depth to the animation. Let's go with a value of 1000 pixels. Next, we need to add a transform style to the container with a value of preserve 3D. Okay, now let's try it again. There, that's much better. It has a much nicer 3D effect now. Now, what if we want to flip the card the other way? Like if we want it to flip to the left instead of to the right? Well, this is really easy. We just need to animate to negative 180 degrees instead. There, now let's save and try this out. So it's subtle, but now it's flipping the opposite direction. And what if we want to flip in a vertical direction instead of horizontal? Well, this is easy too. We just need to switch to rotate on the x-axis instead with the rotate x function. And we'll need to change our CSS value to rotate x too. Okay, now let's try again. Nice, now it's flipping in a vertical direction. So now you have everything you need to create a basic flipping animation. But you don't really need to do all of this if you don't want to. I've been in the process of creating a collection of commonly used UI animations and have been putting them into an installable Angular library called NGX Bootjack Bounce. The idea is that you'll be able to reach for the animations in this library rather than create them from scratch over and over again. So instead, you can install this and use it if you want. Now at the moment, I only have a slide animation and a flip animation in it, but hopefully by the time you're watching this video, there's more available. To use this library, you can install it in your Angular app using this command. Now let's look at how to use it. Let's look at our animation component again. Now, I've already installed the library in this project, so I'm ready to use the animations within it. to add the same animation we just built in the first half of this video, we can add the btj flip horizontal animation function instead of the existing animation. Then we just need to go into the template. Here we can swap out the flip trigger with the btj flip horizontal trigger instead. Now we can go into the SCSS and we can actually include the styles from the library. Then we can remove the perspective, the transform style, the backface visibility, the Z index, the transform, and even the grid from the container. All of these styles are included in the styles from the library, so they can all be removed. Okay, now let's save and see how it looks. Nice, it's working like we'd expect. So that's definitely easier. We can even flip directions with this animation pretty easily too. To do this, we can add the btj flip direction enum from the library and we can use the reverse value. Okay, now let's save and try it again. Nice, now it's flipping the opposite direction. We can also flip the animation in the vertical direction too. To do this, we just need to switch to the btj flip vertical animation function instead. Then we just need to switch the trigger name in the template. Okay, let's save and see how this works. Nice, now it flips vertically. And if we want to slow the animation down or speed it up, we can provide a custom duration with animation params. To do this, let's switch this binding to an object. Then we'll pass a value to this object based on our flipped signal. This will trigger the appropriate state for the animation when the value changes. Next, we can add the params object. And now we can set our duration param. Let's switch to 5 seconds to really slow it down. Okay, now let's save and check it out. And there we go, now it moves really slow. Pretty cool, right? Just makes it a little easier than creating all that yourself and also makes it so you don't need to create the same animations over and over again. Okay, so now you should have a pretty good idea on how to create a basic flip animation in Angular. Realistically, it's pretty easy, right? But if you don't want to create one and maintain it in your project, feel free to use my library. Okay, I guess that's it for now. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you did, check out my channel for more videos on animations and on various other topics and features within Angular. Until next time, thanks for watching.